Hey everyone, today I'll be talking about one of my favorite medium, and that is acrylics. I'll be sharing with you all the basics of acrylic painting that I learned from my experiences. I got a lot of DMs on my Instagram where people were asking me doubts like what canvas should I get, what is the basic that I should know about acrylics, is there anything that I should avoid or do. So I'll try to answer all these questions in today's video. So let's begin. Now we'll look at all the art supplies that you need for acrylics. First thing that you need is obviously acrylic paints. So the paints that I use are from Camlin and they are the artist grade paints. I have used them for the longest period of time and they are perfect and fit right in my budget. So if you are a beginner and you don't want to invest in buying the whole set of acrylics, you can always opt for these small bottles of acrylic paint that you can get it in any stationery shop. In acrylics, you can also get metallic paints or neon paints, so you have a wide range to experiment with. The second thing that you need are canvases. Initially, when I started, I wasn't confident on painting on a larger canvas. I invested in this canvas sheet pad. So basically, these are like loose sheets of canvases. And it is perfect to practice and you can try out the medium, see if it works for you. Slowly, I moved to small canvas boards. So there are two types, one is canvas board and second is stretched canvas. There are multiple sizes and shapes in canvases. You can even find black canvases. You can also paint on glass, wood, or even fabric. There are a lot of shirts that got ruined because of the acrylic stains, so please don't use your new clothes while working with acrylics. Now let's move on to the next part, which is brushes. So the brushes are really important because it will determine what kind of strokes are formed on the canvas. Make sure that the brushes that you use are not too soft or not too stiff. It should be in between. The next art supply that you need are palettes. I will suggest you to keep your acrylic palette different from your other medium palettes because my lazy butt used to use the same palette for all the mediums, that is gouache, watercolors and even acrylics. And once the acrylic paint dries up, it starts chipping, all bits and pieces comes out. So it used to get mixed up with my gouache and watercolors. And then when I used to paint with those mediums, it used to come in between. And you don't need to buy an additional palette. You can always use your ceramic plates, glass plates. The next thing is blending. What I used to do is I used to work with the light color first and then I used to add the dark color. But now what I do is I use the dark paint first and then the light paint. Use the dry brush to blend it. And yeah, that's how I blend my colors. The biggest tip that I would give you guys is that please don't add a lot of water to your acrylic paint. The beauty of working with acrylic paints is working with that thick consistency, forming layers, making textures. And all of that is lost when you add a lot of water in it. Okay, so the next part is after you are done with your painting. I use a varnish coat. So basically this helps me to get a glossy effect on my paintings. And second, it protects from other dust particles. So in varnish, there are different types. There's matte, there's gloss, there's spray varnish, there's liquid varnish. So I use this liquid varnish from Decoy and it has lasted me so long. So yeah, these are all the basic tips. If I have missed anything, make sure to give your thoughts or tips in the comments down below. I would love to read them. I might pin some of your comments. If you still have any questions, you can DM me. If you like this video and if you think that you have learned anything from it, please hit that like button and make sure to subscribe for my content. Thank you so much for watching my video. Yeah, see you next week. Bye.